In this video, we're going to be swapping out this furnace and AC for a good client of mine. It's going to be an interesting one. Wait at the end of the video. I got an announcement to make and you'll see it then. Stay tuned. All right, here we're going to be replacing this old Meridian Consolidated Industries downflow furnace with a new, possibly a cased coil. Morning, Tyler.
Morning.
He's really alive this morning. Yeah, so we're going to be doing an April Air media filter, 20 by 20. New Armstrong furnace, or a Concord furnace, because I couldn't get an Armstrong downflow. 110,000, so it should be fun. We only got about 18 inches down here. And we're gonna be shooting a line set this way through the cross space to the outside. It's about 12 inches cross space, so it should be a great time. I'll see you on the other side. Here's the old AC. This one here is gonna be moving up to the front of the house because of the cross space. This is an old 3.5 lux air unit. It's pretty old. Here's where the new AC is going to go, right here where this pad is. 12-inch crawl space. We got to run a line set through there all the way over to the furnace inside. I have updates. After working on this for 62.38 hours, finally got that off. I'm still trying to get this base up, trying to figure out how that's been put together, but looks like there's literally 5 million screws all the way around that I gotta take off just to get this piece off. Great times. Just a little bit. Wiggle it just a little bit. I have updates. Everything's coming along. Got the line set right down here. We got to get it up underneath, bring it up. I got one more piece of metal to make. Hook up the vents. Gas is done. So it's coming along, coming along. So I got my new stickers today, or actually yesterday. That's my old one. That's my new one. Bleep bloop it down in the comment section below which one you guys like better. That one's kind of glossy. This is matte. That one really sticks out. Yeah, let me know which one you guys like. I have updates. Finally got everything up and running. It's been one of those jobs, been one of those days. Right now I'm doing the old style super heat calculator. So I had 64 degrees, 65 degree wet bulb inside. We're about 87 outside. And so we're showing about 15 degrees super heat. Been adding just a little bit of Freon just to not overshoot it, so I just added a titch and now I gotta let it sit for about 15 minutes and I'll add some more. But we're just about done. I'll get you some shots inside. There, I have updates. Finally done. The vents were just very interesting. This one here is the exhaust, and I had to kind of crisscross up and over. And then this is your intake. And for all that you don't know, you have to make sure your reducing couplings are facing this way, not horizontally, because the water can't drain down. So that's the reason why we ended up cutting in a little bit bigger return. It's moving some air. It's really moving some air. There's the new stickers. Footbridgemedia.com. That's where I get these stickers from. And I tell you what, they were over half off what I paid for those other ones. Very reasonable price for, I think I got 250 of these for like $190. So that's not bad. I think I paid over $500 for the ones that I got from another company. There's my QR code for the filters. So you scan that, takes you right to the website, and you can order the filters, and they're drop shipped right to my customer. So I've been putting them on my furnaces with these type of filters on there. Everything, they're gonna end up sealing up the floor. Everything's done finally. And if you got any value out of this content, smash that thumbs up button. And if you're not subscribed yet, consider subscribing. I have a goal of trying to reach 1,000 subscribers by the end of July, if possible. And I need your help. And if you've been watching the channel and not subscribed yet, that'd be great. Subscribe to the channel. And if you're the one smashing that thumbs down, do that twice. That'd be great. See you in the next one.